yourselves.
I'm a UX engineer and based in Athens, Greece. I'm also a core team member at GitLab. I've been contributing for a year or so. At work, I lead the further engineering efforts and UX design. And at GitLab, I participate primarily in discussions around triage operations, developer productivity, and also response time for community contributions and mentoring and engaging other community members with their contributions. So this started about a half a year ago. I decided I wanted to give back to open source by contributing, and GitLab seemed like a really nice project for me. Back then I had zero experience with Ruby, Aspect, SAS, and most of the technology stack behind GitLab. So during the first months, I was always trying to reverse engineer parts of the code and see what I can fix. I remember that every time I ran into any issue, I was thinking, could I fix this? Is this interesting for me to pick up? And this actually led from zero to one, learning about a lot about front-end engineering and testing standards in an open source project that is a production grade project. It's worth noting that half of the contribution I've made during that time, I wasn't sure that they could make it through and make it within the product. Another thing that was also beneficial was actually learning about view components, a view in general. I was doing this for some months, and then I noticed that the front-end team at Vue actually started utilizing Vue from the front-end architecture. I had very little experience with Vue back then. I had to try locally all changes and push for a merge request and see what happened. During that time, every time I ran into a merge request from a front-end team member at GitLab, I studied the review comments and some of the changes they made. So learning, you can learn so much by reading other people's code. This is not obvious maybe at first, but almost everything I know about Vue, I've learned through reading merge requests and code reviews from the front-end team at GitLab. One of the smallest but impactful contributions that I made back then was adding the shortcut button to the Markdown editor to insert a Markdown table ready to use. I was actually struggling to copy and paste the Markdown code every day back then. So when you start collaborating with the team members at GitLab or start contributing, you actually notice this for the very first time, that you are about to welcome to enter a very welcoming community. GitLab core values are embodied in every small interaction between team members and also the wider community. So this led to receiving so much support while contributing makes you want to be more supportive in your day-to-day workflows. So I try to bring this in at my day job and actually improve collaboration with my colleagues and the other team members. So of course, not everything looks good. Maybe contributing regularly actually can be fulfilling, but as you gradually pick up larger and more complicated issues, GitLab works asynchronously and a distributed team, an all remote team. They know how to work remotely, effectively, and efficiently. So when I started doing this, I was a bit hyped and or maybe excited about this, and started being all around the clock and responding to comments, and during weekends too. The top image here is my activity during the first months, which there were no breaks, and working during weekends also. On the bottom, while more a bit intense and focused, I decided to take some breaks and actually not avoid working during the weekends and contributing during that time. So what I can advise here is that you can take it easy pace. Asynchronous collaboration takes time. All remote teams like GitLab know how to work and handle all this workload. But when you start contributing, maybe it's best to try to ping people near your time zone. This will make response time better and avoid working too much. This also led to some burnout during the first months, but we got over it soon. Another thing is that after contributing for a year or two, I ran into the design system pajamas, which actually powers the product, and the it's a collaboration between the UX and front-end teams that create reusable components in Vue. And realizing that this is exciting for me, I jumped into component implementation and tried to help collaborate wherever I could. This includes actively working with front-end engineers, product designers, and getting involved in discussions about the design system and future steps. Currently, the design system powers around 400 user interface components that are used within the product. So being part of this, helping scaling the design system and utilizing components within the software development lifecycle of the GitLab product is actually what fascinates me more at the moment. And I'm really enjoying this. Another thing that I noticed is that practicing code reviews and collaborating with merge requests, which is the standard way of collaborating at GitLab, also enabled me to adopt this kind of workflows at my day job and every side project I work on. Having access to the handbook, which is an open handbook that includes how engineering workflows work at GitLab, it was also eye-opening for me. And I was inspired by these workflows related to code reviews and cross-functional team members, teams. And every time while contributing, I had to go through the code review and the merge request. So I was wondering if this could be something that I could adopt at work. So forking the workflows of the GitLab and adopting similar practices actually improved the development lifecycle and allowed to work more effectively across cross-functional teams. Of course, it took months to adopt the mindset of the DevOps team across teams and projects, from planning, issue tracking, to CI/CD, that is build, test, and deploy. So for me, it's clear that the DevOps is the new way to go and the standard new way of building and deploying modern applications. Future steps could include integrating also security in the development lifecycle, which is also important. We also tried recently a project where we actually shipped, and on day one, we had around two critical vulnerabilities and 45 vulnerabilities in the front-end code. That was because we didn't pay attention to dependency scanning and vulnerabilities that were published for these packages. So that's it for me. Thanks for listening. If you have any questions, feel free to ask me later.